Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. As it was in the beginning, it is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell, lead all souls to heaven, especially those most in need of thy mercy. Holy Queen, Mother of Mercy, our life, our sweetness, and our hope, to thee we cry, poor banished children of Eve. To thee we send up our sighs, mourning and weeping in this valley of tears. Turn then, O most gracious Advocate, thine eyes of mercy towards us, and after this our exile, show unto us the blessed fruit of thy womb, Jesus. O clement, O loving, O sweet Virgin Mary, that we be made worthy of the promise of Christ. Amen. Thank you.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, John.
My name is John Siebert, and I've been in this parish for a long time. And I got a call last night, not too late, but somebody asked me if I wanted to speak on the Eucharist of our event to me. So I said no. And then I thought, well, there's probably not a real long line of people that want to do this. So maybe I better take my turn and get out of the way. So here I am. This morning at 3 o'clock, I woke up and I said, you got to do it. You can't pass on this, you got to do it. So at 3 o'clock in the morning, I started thinking, what does the Eucharist mean to me? I don't know. You know, I thought I knew what it meant. But when I was in grade school, which was a long time ago, we seldom used the word Eucharist. We used communion and Holy Communion. And I thought that they were interchangeable. And I told Father that, and I kind of got the impression, he didn't say yes or no, but I kind of got the impression that they weren't interchangeable. They may mean something a little different. One may have a little bit more attached to it than the other. So I thought about it some more, and I think that I've decided that for me, it seems that Holy Communion is something we do at Mass. And it really doesn't extend much further than that. It's an action that occurs at Mass. Whereas the Eucharist is something that's here all the time. We have veneration on First Friday, and we venerate the Eucharist. And to me, that means it's something good. So what I came up with, for me, this kind of makes sense. Communion fits in a box. We do it at Mass, has special time, and it's kind of something we can measure. Whereas the Eucharist, on the other hand, is big. It won't fit in a box. It's not something we can measure or determine the dimensions of. It's certainly something much bigger than what I think it is, and we're fortunate over the next couple months to have Father articulate for us the meaning of the Eucharist. And hopefully, if we pay attention, we'll have a better understanding of the Eucharist and what it means for all of our lives. Thank you very much. Have a good evening and enjoy communion at Mass today.
Thank you.
Your spirit.
We celebrate today the meeting of Jesus in the Eucharist. And in order to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, we first call to mind our sins. Lord Jesus, you bring us to new life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
Almighty God, have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins. Bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest,
and on earth peace to the people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only God's Son, Lord God, take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us.
For you alone are the Holy One,
you alone are the Lord, you alone are
the Most High, Jesus Christ, the Holy Spirit, the Lord God, the Father.
Amen.
Let us pray.
Nations before him, and making things run in his service. Oh.
the way of God in accordance with the truth? Are you not? And you're not concerned with anyone's opinion, for you do not regard a person's status. Tell us then, what is your opinion? Is it lawful to pay the census tax to Caesar or not? Knowing the matters, Jesus said, why are you testing me, you hypocrites? Show me the coin that pays the census tax. They handed him the Roman coin, and he said to them, whose image is this and whose inscriptions? They replied, Caesar's. That he said to them, then repay to Caesar what belongs to Caesar, and then to God what belongs to God. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Okay, so I refer to this weekend, we're beginning at one of four sermons about Jesus and the Eucharist. And today's title is Jesus, the Eucharist, and the Paschal Mystery. And, you know, what does that mean, right? And so, I started thinking about it. You know, but anyways, beginning thinking about it, we were caught up with so many things, especially seeing the recent years when we all talk about it, things keep getting worse, whether it's for our personal lives, whether it's anxiety, tension, wars, our nation. We can go on and on. And especially right now, in Israel, the situation there is it's atrocious, right? There are atrocities going on. And how do we make sense of such things? I don't have answers, really. But I know a lot of times when there's tragedies and difficulties, say a funeral or a tragedy or somebody with illness, and people of faith say, I don't know how we do it, how about that? Pierced with the lance. It's interesting, right? How I found the outline for the talk, believe it or not, I checked the bishop's website, and he was supposed to have something, and I couldn't find it. And so I just Googled Jesus, yeah, the way, Pastor Mystery of the Eucharist, and it came up with some great, great sort of liners. And so, one of them is that, I can't find it exactly because I was going on my own, but when I get, I'll get to it, I'll get okay, so, how do we save us? He shed his blood. He died for us and rose from the dead. And in this he saved us. How does this happen? Does Jesus die over and over again? No. So I learned about this in my first year of theology. Father Paulinus, he was like in his 80s and he just read the script, you know, and in a pretty dry way, he listened to me at a lot of depth. And he's from St. Mary's, he was 87 years old, and I find that, that Pat Pearson is his cousins, and when I came here to New Boys, she had him over for dinner, and they're like, you know, but anyways, we were about the church fathers, early church fathers, and what they said about all kinds of things, and especially about the liturgy, and does Jesus die over and over again? And that's no. I learned about this, you know, that no. And here we go, at the Mass, God breaks through the limits of time. And enters into the eternal. God brings you to the limits of time. We enter into the moments of the Last Supper, of Good Friday, and Easter. He did it only once, but we enter into the eternal. And when we do that, we're saved. We're right at the moment, especially in the Holy Holies. You know, we're going to heaven and earth, the angels and the saints, the communion of saints, and we pray. Consecration and the bread and wine, the body and blood of Christ, and it's entering. Jesus did it once, and we're there. We're into that now, the present, and He saves us. And I find that fascinating and amazing. This is the Paschal mystery. Salvation is just not the past; it is now. So. I don't know how to get through life without the Eucharist. In addition to everything I just said, when I receive Holy Communion, I receive Jesus saving me. On the cross, now. Resurrected, now. Forgiven, I am forgiven, now. He's always with me, now and always. Last word is deliverance, deliverance. I look up at that. What does deliverance mean? Rescued from sin. Danger and evil, rescued from sin, danger and evil. At Mass, I am delivered. When I see communion, I am delivered. I am free. That's something. Free by the Lord, free by Jesus. At this Eucharist, may we be more aware of the Paschal mystery. In me and in Mass, God continue to help us, the Holy Spirit continue to inspire us, in the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead. we pray.
Guide
us, Lord. For world leaders, that they may seek diplomatic solutions to conflict and war, we pray.
Guide
us, Lord.
For all God's people, that formed in the image and likeness of God, we will manifest God's presence in our workplaces, our families, and our society, we pray.
Guide us, Lord.
That during this Eucharistic revival, we ask Jesus to help us to believe that what he accomplished through his passion, death, resurrection, and ascension is a gift of grace for us, we pray.
Guide
us, O Lord.
For all who will be voting, that the Spirit of God will help them recognize the critical issues before them and guide them in applying the gospel messages in their choices, we pray.
Guide
us, O Lord.
For greater respect for life, that the Holy Spirit will open all to a deeper recognition of the beauty and mystery of life in all its stages, we pray.
Guide
us, O Lord.
For our local economy and our community, we pray.
Guide us, O Lord.
For our community churches, especially for the members of St. John Lutheran Church, we also pray for Father Felix and the members of San Antonio, our sister parish in the Yucatan, that the Spirit of God will help us grow in unity, we pray.
Guide
us, Lord.
For our beloved deceased, and for the deceased members of St. Mark CDOA, who we remember in a special way at this liturgy, and for all who have died recently, may they experience the love and mercy of Jesus and rest in his heavenly peace, we pray.
Guide us, Lord.
For peace in Israel, Ukraine, the United States, and the world, and any intentions you'd like to voice at this time.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to the apostle, peace I leave, it is my peace that I give to you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will. You live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen.
And with your spirit.
We share a sign of peace. spring will occur right now today after this Mass, and then after that, again, there will not be Mass until spring at St. James Church in Driftwood. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And God's blessing upon you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.